Hey guys, what's going on? Jeff here from Films at Home, and in today's 4K review, we're going to check out a 4K disc that somehow I have overlooked, and a lot of you guys told me that I needed to check out. Today, we're looking at Mortal Engines on 4K Blu-ray for this review. So Mortal Engines, the movie that came out back in 2018, and I just completely overlooked it. I didn't hear good things about it. It didn't get great reviews in the theaters, so I skipped it there. Then when it came out on disc, I just didn't give it much thought. I completely missed it. It's from Universal, so I'm actually surprised that I didn't actually get it back in the day. Usually I get a lot of the Universal titles. I somehow just totally overlooked this one. But you guys have been telling me for a long time when I've been doing top 10 videos and best 4Ks of, 2019, 2020, 2018, that this is one I really needed to take a look at. So I grabbed it off Amazon and I was able to check it out just recently. So jumping right into the review here to talk about the visuals, that is where I am super impressed with this release and could consider this the best digitally shot 4K that I've seen. I think there are 4K releases that I like better that are from film transfers, things like Jaws or The Shining or 2001 A Space Odyssey, because I can really appreciate that the 4K transfer and the upscale from what was previously there, all the work that had to go into the restoration. But this one was digitally shot, and it was actually shot at 8K and then does have a 4K digital intermediate. So even with all that CGI, the 4K here is absolutely stunning, and it is a good example of if we can get digital 4K intermediates and they aren't digitally shot and then they're 2K upscales, this format has a ton of potential, not just for, movies shot on film, but also for newer stuff. But you've got to have that 4K digital intermediate and shoot it at a very high resolution like they did here. It is awesome. I have never seen a disc that's so detailed. This easily surpasses Joker, which was my previous standout for digitally shot 4K. This surpasses Gemini Man for me, which was another one that was shot at a very high resolution and finished in 4K. This disc is awesome. The detail here is incredible. I have never seen something so detailed. This is possibly the best 4K disc that I've seen. It's not the biggest leap in quality from Blu-ray to 4K. That's where I give a thumbs up to, 2001, The Shining, Jaws, things like that. But man, what a beautiful, beautiful picture. This is absolutely reference quality. You guys were 100% right. I don't know how I missed this. If you're just looking for something to show off your screen, wow, what a picture. And then the HDR on it as well just pops. I mean, everything across the board. I'm not surprised because of who was involved with this. Peter Jackson was on board with this, which means that all of his resources were involved, and there was a lot of money backing this release, and it's based on a very popular book. It had a lot going for it and just kind of bombed at the box office, but there's a ton of technical merit to this release that, even if you don't love the movie, this is the highest quality disc that I probably have ever seen. So I could go on and on and on about the visuals, but I mean, it is down to even the nitty gritty, details on people's clothing, fine details and the landscapes and on the machines themselves that are traveling across the world. And wow, really, really, really detailed. And you're gonna love that. And then that HDR does pop very nicely. I should mention as well, HDR 10, and Dolby Vision on this. Again, this is one where did I see a huge difference between HDR 10 and the Dolby Vision? Not necessarily, but the Dolby Vision I think is the better option, but it's, we're splitting hairs there. So either way, whether you have Dolby Vision or not, you're gonna get a great experience, and it's hands down easily one of the best discs that I've ever looked at. Now, audio wise, this does have a great Atmos track, which is really surround heavy. I mean, this thing, if you don't have all your surround sound speakers, you don't have your height speakers, you're gonna really want the full system for this. Otherwise, you're probably not gonna get the most out of it through just a sound bar or a 2.1. But even if you just have a 5.1, there was so much surround sound action here. If you don't have surround sound, you'll miss out on it. But even a 5.1 system is gonna get a workout with this release. And if you get those height speakers and you can add that Atmos effect, it's even better. It's a really, really nice track. And then it maintains, dialogue stays very clear. front channel is nice and clear. You don't miss out on anything. So it's not like a Tenet experience where like Tenet had great sound and it wasn't Atmos, but it had great sound, great surround effects, but you couldn't hear the dialogue. You don't mess with that here. Dialogue still remains very clear. It's a very balanced mix. The bass action was actually the only area it's like a little bit lacking. I felt like a lot of the bass was maybe spread out across all the channels, and the subwoofer itself and the really low, low frequency stuff wasn't like overwhelming. I think it had a chance to be like really, really good, and they just kind of missed on that. But that's such a minor complaint because the rest of the Atmos track is very solid. I mean, it really... There are a few Atmos tracks out there which you're like, ah, yeah, it has Atmos, but it doesn't really do much with the surrounds. And, you know, it's kind of, it's there because it's a nice marketing term. Ah, we can put Atmos on the disc. This one is Atmos with full Atmos effect. I mean, it felt like I was watching something in an IMAX theater. Like, you really do get that experience with this movie. So I highly, highly recommend it, both visually and from an audio standpoint. This is a great, great 4K disc that if you're just a fan of the format, you have to have this in your collection, regardless of what you think of the movie. It's such a workout for your system. And it's not that bad a movie. Honestly, I think it gets a bad rap, and a lot of people kind of were tough on it. And, you know, maybe it just missed the mark. It's the type of movie that, you know, where we had the Hunger Games and Allegiant, the Divergent series, and, you know, all these other like teen things coming out, like the sci-fi stuff. I think this one just got kind of overlooked. It's not terrible, so you'll still have like a decent experience. It's like a 6 out of 10 movie, but a 10 out of 10 disc. Packaging wise, it's pretty straightforward. Buying it off Amazon just a couple weeks ago, no slip cover, you're just getting this case. It was about $10. Does come with a digital copy, which should redeem in 4K. And then your 4K disc does have some artwork on it. No special features on the 4K disc, which I really can't blame them for, because given this is a 4K digital intermediate with Atmos and the quality of this transfer, like, I'm sure that it filled the disc. So all the special features are on the Blu-ray, but you get a little 5-part behind the scenes, the kind of how they put a whole city on wheels, basically London, End of the Ancients, In the Air, a character series. It's really kind of baseline stuff. There's nothing really special. So if you're a super fan, you don't get a ton, but that Welcome to London, a little 5-part like docu-series is pretty nice. So really basic on that front, packaging and special features, but I don't really care about that because the rest of it is so damn good that that would overrule anything else from packaging special feature standpoint. So overall, like, this is a disc you have to have. This is a 10 out of 10 disc for visuals. This is an easy like 9.5 out of 10 for audio. It's one of the best discs I've ever seen, and I picked it up for only $10 on Amazon, which, you know, that is a steal. If you can get a 4K disc for $10, whether it's an upgrade or just a new release like this that you're picking up for your collection, that's a really good deal. You're not going to get your slipcover or stuff that may have came with the first print run, but who cares about that stuff when you're getting a disc that's this good? Don't overlook this movie like I did just because of the reviews. It's not that bad. It is entertaining, but even more so if you have the right system and you've got your 4K TV or projector and you've invested in that and you've got Atmos, this is the disc. You can watch this disc over and over again and just be super impressed with how far home media, physical media has come, because this is like the pinnacle. This is right at the peak with things like 2001 and Joker and Gemini Man and The Shining and Jaws and stuff that just has been blowing me away lately. This is right there with them. It holds its own and is probably even better than a lot of them. So highly, highly, highly recommend it. I'll leave a link down in the description where you can pick it up. That would help support my channel if you use that. But also, it's available at many other retailers. So shop around and find it. But it's well worth, you know, $10 to $12. That's such a steal. I would have paid $20 for this at release if I hadn't just overlooked it completely. So that's it for the review. Check out all the links down in my description for ways you can support the channel and to pick up Mortal Engines on 4K. Also, check out other ways to follow me on Instagram, on TikTok, where we actually have 2,500 followers now on TikTok. There is an actual physical media community over there, and some other YouTube channels have started as well. So if you haven't downloaded it, it's not bad. There's actually some content there, and I think it's going to grow and be really big. So I recommend you checking us out there, and then check out all the other links for ways you can support the channel. And of course, please subscribe so you can help us hit our 100,000 subscriber goal for 2021. That would be awesome. If you enjoy this content, that's a great way to support without needing to do anything. Click one button, and I appreciate your support there. So thank you for watching. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Stay safe and stay healthy out there. Go Bucks. Go Tom Brady. I don't care if I'm a Pats fan. I'm rooting for Tom Brady in the Super Bowl tomorrow. But yeah, have a great rest of your weekend, and I'll talk to you soon.